Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. This is another episode of Seagull on the Speed 252. Today is going to be a great day out because it's right now 75 degrees. It's going to be nice and warm. And I'm looking forward to being outside today, but unfortunately we won't be outside in the Grand Sport. As you all know that my rotors was warped. And a couple of you said to me, take some time to see if they're actually been warped. But the dealership decided to cover these on their own expense, so I didn't really go through the extra mile to actually see if they're really warped or not. They already ordered me a brand new set, so I'm really thankful for that. And like I said, the dealership here, they really take care of me. I love the guys over there. They do a great job. And I just appreciate the things that they do. And I'm very thankful and grateful to have them, part of my channel and my life, because those guys are really great. We can get along and we talk just fine about everything. But so, yes, I did order my new ceramic brake pads. I am super, super, super excited about those jerks because I am so sick of this brake dust. So I will talk about which brake pads I did order because, as my channel grows, I listen and read each and every one of your comments. And I went in and actually tally up which ones that everyone recommended. And I just, literally through every comment. And I give you that feedback here shortly. But one thing I want to talk about is one of my subscribers asked me, how come you don't ever make any videos on the Camaro? Well, I made an earlier video about, the Camaro and why I bought it and things like that. I bought a Camaro because when I first seen that body style, I was definitely drawn to it. My favorite movie is the Transformers and the Titanic, by the way. That's some personal stuff I give you about me in this video. And when I seen the Transformers, like, it was just an incredible car. Like, when it transformed, I immediately thought I was inside of the car. I was like, dang, like, this is a freaking looking car. And Bumblebee was just, it's extraordinary. I mean, he was just super, super awesome. And he was one of the characters in the movie that, pretty much stand out above all the other characters, right? You have Bumblebee, who just took care of everybody. He was like Optimus Prime, right-hand man, and he was an awesome looking car. And so that was the reason why I bought the Camaro. And the Camaro is a V6, right? So I don't know if I told you this. I have said this in an earlier video that the Camaro is a V6. So it's not really a V8. It's not that fast. At the time when I bought it, I was considering my sports car because the V6 was all I knew. I never drove a V8 at the time, and it was in my price range. And so right now, I don't feel like making any videos on the V6 Camaro will really do anything for the channel because it is kind of, it's an old 5th-gen V6. When, if I had a V8, 15, it might be a totally different story, but right now it's kind of like my daily driver, and it's possible that I may end up selling it at some point. I haven't fully decided on it just yet. I will say honestly, that car hasn't given me any problems since I own it. It's a 2011. It has 74,000 miles on it. I bought it with 25,000 miles on it, and I haven't had any problems out of that car at all. I mean, like, not a thing. And so when I bought the Grand Sport, it seems like I haven't a lot of issues with the Grand Sport, but that just comes with wear and tear on the vehicle, as because it's man-made. And honestly, I have tracked this car, I have dragged this car, so it's just one of those things where, like, you expected the things to go happen. Now, when you start having issues with electrical problems and things like that, that's when you start to have problems. It's a perfect example. My friend that I was telling you about that had a C7 2015 Corvette, they took their car in for the slipping transmission, and the dealership replaced that transmission. And they brought it back, and it kept, still jerking a lot. So they actually just traded a car in recently, about 3 weeks ago, for a 2019 Corvette Stingray. Well, that new 2019 Corvette Stingray just got towed to the dealership from their house because when they mashed the start button, the car didn't start. And they pressed it again. The car had a delay in the start, and so they took it to the dealership. Dealership said, we think something's wrong with your electronics or your electrical work. And honestly, when it comes down to electrical working with cars these days, if you're having issues with that, I think it's hard for those things to be diagnosed. I don't know, that's just me, but if I had electrical issues with my car, I wouldn't want to keep it at that point. I mean, I just feel like when you get into all the electrical stuff, unless you have a computer that can tell you exactly what is going on with that electrical stuff, you'll be digging in that stuff for days. So I feel bad for them because this is their second, Stingray, and these cars are great. They're great for the money, they're great for the buy, they're great for the horsepower that you get out of them. And I truly do like my Grand Sport. One of my followers was like, I'm surprised you haven't even got rid of your Grand Sport with as many problems you had with it, and you don't seem really down and out about your Grand Sport. Well, I grew up in the second, poorest town in the United States, like literally the second poorest town in the United States, and I feel like you know, growing up there, I worked hard to try to get out of that area, to try to get out of that bad area where nothing was positive going on, except whatever you decide to do for yourself, right? And so, looking back then, I never really thought I was going to own a Corvette. And now that I have one, it's one of those things where, like, you know, you can control your happiness. I'm not going to sit here and let a car make me all sad and depressed. There's no reason for that. Now, do I get a little ticked because things go wrong? But yeah, but that's just the way things are, because it's man-made. You know, things are bound to break down. But I'm not going to let that control my happiness, and I'm not going to let that control my life in general. And, you know, I love making YouTube videos, and I love, you know, showing my personal side and my... Yeah, I'm not going to let, you know, the little things that's happening to the Corvette bring down my energy and vibe just because, you know, it is what it is. Like, I grew up in the second, you know, poorest town in the United States. I'm not going to let that happen. But we need to go to the dealership because I'm actually running a little bit behind. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get this bad boy started. Let's get this video started. And I actually may try to record a little bit of this today in the dealership. I may actually try to record him actually putting on the brake pads and taking one off and putting one on just for the video and see how that actually goes. Because I never actually seen it done on a Corvette before. I have seen it done on my previous cars. And I actually, on my daily driver, I changed the brake pads and rotors myself. And, you know, since the rotors on this Corvette is covered by the dealership, I didn't see the need to really me doing it myself. You know, it doesn't really make any sense. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get this video started. I hope you're having a great day. I thank you for tuning in. If you are watching this, please subscribe to the channel. I love how you're part of the community. You know, we're definitely growing day by day. And I loved all the comments that each and every one of you leave. And I just, you know, I'm just really grateful. And once again, I appreciate it. And so let's go ahead and get this car started and let's get on the road. So these are the new rotors that are actually getting put on today. And these are the old ones. They don't look that bad, but they're definitely heavy, that's for sure. Thank you everyone for watching this upload. I wanted to make the ending kind of while I was driving, but unfortunately I feel like with the course of exhaust and a loud engine and everything else, that it would be probably hard for you to hear me talk over those things. So I just want to kind of back up in the garage and talk about, you know, the new rotors being put on. And honestly, I think that did the trick. You know, like I said before, there was a lot of vibration in the steering wheel while I was driving, and now all that is gone. All that is played out due to the new rotors being installed. As y'all know, I ordered ceramic hard brake pads. Those on the car right now. So I'm going to figure out, you know, a few weeks from now, how well these are with the brake dust and see how well, you know, they perform on the car. Most everybody in the chat, you know, recommended that brand. So I went along with that brand, but I am planning to check out some other brands along the way, you know, when these wore out, and see exactly how I like those as well. Cause there've been a lot of recommendations in the chat below. So I want to kind of, you know, try out some different brands along the way to figure out which brand I want to stick with going forward. The drawing for the Corvette hat is still going on. All you have to do is subscribe, like, and comment down below. That will enter you in a drawing to win this Corvette hat. Pretty cool hat with the Nike sign behind it. pretty cool, pretty cool. Thank you for watching this channel. Thank you for watching this upload for everyone that pushed that play button. I am going to Corvettes and Call Out, which is the 23rd to the 26th. If you're a big fan of Corvettes, you don't want to miss this event. From what I was told, this event is going to be extravagant. There's going to be so many Corvettes. If you got a Corvette, you don't want to miss it. Come out there. Come take a look at all the other cars out there. Come take a look at the Silver Bullet as well. And I would love to meet you and greet you. And I will have some merch out there. The October 20th will be the YouTube call out. I don't know any more information about that just yet. Mike hasn't released anything, so I'm looking forward to that as well. Let's see. Oh, you do not, I repeat, you do not want to miss Friday's episode. I did a review on a car. Nothing fancy, nothing too extreme. I think this car probably costs around like $49,000. You don't want to miss that episode. I talked about this car before in the past, a long, long time ago on a previous episode in the very beginning. And, you know, I always want to review one. I don't think I will be able to buy one, but I would love for y'all to check out the episode. You do not want to miss Friday's episode. It's going to be freaking amazing. I can tell you that for sure. With that being said, please subscribe. Please like. Please leave a comment down below. And if you would like to have your car featured on my channel, please send me an email at seagonaspeed252@gmail.com. And put in, you know, in the subject line your name, your first name, and then, you know, your car. And then also, if you'd like to send me cool stuff to be featured on the channel and I would like to receive some cool things, please send them to P.O. Box 52504 Durham, North Carolina 27717. So that way I can feature some of those things on the channel. And, you know, like I said, let's all grow together. And thank you for watching this episode, and let's see some of your cool rides.